Mr. Angel, please. Mr. Angel, allow me to introduce my client, Monsieur Louis Safar.
Hi, Harry Angel.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Angel. I don't want to appear rude or impolite, but do you have any ID, stuff like that, before we begin?
Sure, yeah, here. Yeah. Oh, let's see what I got. How's that?
Nothing personal. It's just that I'm a little overcautious. You know how these things are.
Oh, I know. So, how did you, hear about me? I guess you guys, just looked in the phone book, huh? Huh? Usually that's what happens, because my name is Angel, it's under A's, people, you know, people are lazy. They flick through, they see the first name in a book, and,
Johnny Favorite.
Excuse me?
Do you by chance remember the name Johnny Favorite?
You remember the name Johnny? No, I don't think so.
You never knew him?
Am I supposed to know him?
He was a crooner before the war, quite famous in his way.
Uh-huh. Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Safier, you know, I...
Mr. Cipher.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry, Mr. Cyphers. I usually don't get involved in anything really heavy. I usually handle small-time stuff, insurance jobs, divorces, things of that nature. I get lucky sometimes I handle people. But I don't know no, you know, crooners or anybody famous, you know?
His real name was Liebling.
I don't know any Liebling either. So what is it that you guys want from me? Does this man owe you money or something?
Not quite. I gave Johnny some help at the beginning of his career.
So were you his, like, his agent?
No. Oh, nothing so.
Monsieur Cipher has a contract. Certain collateral was involved to be forfeited in the event of his death.
Losing me a little bit. We're talking about a guy who's dead?
No, he was drafted. 43, North Africa. Special Entertainment Services. There was an attack. He was badly injured about the head and face. He had...
Amnesia, I think you call it,
Shell shock.
Shell shock, yes.
I know how that feels.
Why, were you in the services, Mr. Angel?
Yes, I was in for a short period of time, but I got a little fucked up real quick, excuse my language, you know, and they shipped me back home, and I sort of missed the whole shebang, you know, the war, the medals, all 9 yards, and I guess you could say I was lucky.
Well, Johnny wasn't so lucky. He returned home a virtual zombie.
Favorite's friends had him transferred to a private hospital upstate. There was some sort of radical psychiatric treatment involved. Favorite's lawyers had the power of attorney to
pay the bills, things like that. But you know how these things are. He remained a vegetable and my contract was never honored.
See?
I don't want to sound mercenary or anything, but you must understand that my interest in Johnny is only in finding out if he's alive or if he's dead.
Each year, my office receives a signed affidavit confirming that Johnny Liebling is indeed among the living. Until this last weekend when... quite by chance, Monsieur Cipher and I were in the vicinity of the hospital just outside Poughkeepsie. We decided to check for ourselves, but we're given misleading information.
Hey, the runaround.
Yes, I didn't want to cause a scene. I hate to have any sort of fuss, so I thought perhaps you could, you know, subtly in a more quiet manner.
You want me to check it out?
Check it out.
Okay. Yeah.
It's funny, I have a feeling I've met you before.
I don't know. I don't think so.